जय राधा माधवा कुंज बिहारी,
Om Namah Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Bhagavad Gita, chapter 18, text number 48.
我们今天阅读《国家梵歌原意》第十八章第四十八诗节。
Sahajam,
Sahajam,
Karma Kaunteya,
Karma Kaunteya,
Sadosham,
Sadosham,
Apinachyajat,
Apinachyajat.
Sarvaramba,
Sarvaramba,
Nidoshena,
Nidoshena,
Dumenagnir, Devavrita,
Devavrita,
Sahajam Karma Kaunteya,
Sahajam Karma Kaunteya.
Sadosham apinachyajet
Sadosham apinachyajet
Sarvaramba hidoshena
Sarvaramba hidoshena
Dumenagnir ivavrita
Dumenagnir
ivavrita
Sahajam Karma Kaunteya
Sahajam Karma Kaunteya
Sadosham Apinachyajet
Sadosham Apinachyajet
Sarvaramba Hidoshena
Sarvaramba Hidoshena
Dumenakneri Vavrata
Dumenakneri Vavrata
Sahajam Karma Kaunteya
Sadosham
apinachyajet
Sadosham apinachyajet
Sarvaramba hidoshena
Sarvaramba hidoshena
Dumenagnir ivavrita
Dumenagnir ivavrita
Sahaja karma kaunteya
Sahaja karma kaunteya Sadosham apinachyajet
Sarvaramba hidoshena
Sarvaramba hidoshena
Dumenagnir ivavrita
Dumenagnir ivavrita
Sahajam karma kaunteya
Sahajam karma kaunteya
Sadosham apinachyajet
Sadosham apinachyajetSavaramba hidoshena
Dumenagni ivavrita
Dumenagni ivavrita
Sahajam karma kaunteya
Sahajam karma kaunteya
Sadosham apinachyajet
Sadosham apinachyajet
Savaramba hidoshena
Savaramba hidoshena
Dumenagni ivavrita
Sahajam karma kaunteya
Sahajam karma kaunteya
Sadosham apinachyajet
Sadosham apinachyajet
Sarvaramba hidoshena
Sarvaramba hidoshena
Dumenagnir ivavrita
Dumenagnir ivavrita
Sahajam karma kaunteya
Sahajam karma kaunteya
Sadosham apinachyajet
Sadosham apinachyajet
Sarvaramba hidoshena
Sarvaramba hidoshena
Dumenagnir ivavrita
Dumenagnir ivavrita
Sahajam
Sahajam
同时产生，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作，工作
Sarva Arambha.
Sarva Arambha.
一切冒险。
一切冒险。
He.
肯定的。
肯定的。
Doshena.
Doshena.
被缺点。
被缺点。
Dumena.
Dumena.
被淹。
被淹。
Agni.
Agni.
火。
火。
Eva.
Eva.
正如。
正如。
Avrita.
Avrita.
覆盖。
覆盖。
译文：每一份努力都被某些弱点笼罩，正如火被浓烟遮蔽一样。因此，昆提之子呀，人不应放弃来自本性的工作，即使这样的工作布满缺陷。圣帕帕德要指，在受限制的生命中，所有的工作都受到物质自然形态的污染，即使是婆罗门。也得举行需要杀死动物的献祭。同样，无论一位刹帝利有多虔诚，也必须杀敌而不可逃避。无论怎样虔诚的商人，有时也必须隐瞒利润，以便继续做下去，或者有时也可能做黑市买卖，这些都是必须的，不可避开。同样，一位疏可服务的，即使是个坏主人，他也得照主人的吩咐去做，即使本不该那样去做。尽管有这些缺陷，人还得继续履行其固定职责，因为那是由自己的本性而生的。这里举了一个很精辟的例子：火虽然纯净，却仍有烟冒出来。然而，烟并不能使火变得不纯净。火中即使有烟，也还是被认为是所有元素中最纯净的。如果谁硬要放弃刹帝利的工作而抄起婆罗门的职分，他并不能保证在婆罗门的职分中就没有令人不快的责任。因此可以下结论，在物质世界里，没有人能完全免除物质自然的污染。这里举的烟和火的例子是再恰当不过的。冬天里从火中取出石头，青烟有时会熏眼睛或伤到身体的其他部分。然而尽管如此，人们还需用火。同样，人不可因为一些不顺心的境况就放弃自己的天职，相反，应决心坚定地在 Krishna 之觉中以自己的天职服务至尊主，这就是完美的境界。当某一特定职分用于满足至尊主时，这特定职分中的所有缺陷都被净化。当工作的结果被净化，当与奉爱服务联系起来时，人就会逐渐完美地看到内在的自我，而这就是觉悟自我。
Thank you. Arjuna was reluctant to execute his duty as a kshatriya.
Arjuna 忽视了他作为查崔亚需要去履行的职责。
But Lord Krishna, by explaining the principles of yoga, he's encouraging Arjuna that he should do what is his prescribed duty.
那么主 Krishna 通过描述了瑜伽的原则来鼓励 Arjuna 去按照他的本性履行规定的职责。
And of course, Arjuna may be thinking that he could do some other duty better.
也许 Arjuna 在想他可以去更好地做别的工作。
He's thinking, better if I was a Brahmana, I would be a good Brahmana.
他想呢，也许我当一个婆罗门会更好，也许我成为婆罗门会更好。
But Krishna says, well, that's not your nature, Arjuna. You don't have the Brahman nature.
但是主 Krishna 却说到呢， Arjuna, 这不是你的本性。Arjuna, 你不具备这个婆罗门的天性。
His nature is to fight.To manage, to control others.
Arjuna 的本性是在战场上作战，并且去做管理，去和其他的人作战。
To protect people.
以及去保护人们。
So in the verse today, Lord Krishna is giving a very nice example that he compares, he talks about fire, just like when you light a fire.There's also smoke, and smoke is not very pleasant.
主 Krishna 在这个世界当中举出了一个例子，他举了这个火的例子。当这个火被点燃的时候，也会冒出这个浓烟。这个浓烟并不是令人愉快的。
In the beginning, when you light a fire, then in the beginning, first phase will be there will be some smoke, and make your eyes water, give some disturbance.
当你刚开始点起火的时候，这个火就会产生出浓烟，让你的眼睛流出泪水，让你觉得感到受打扰。
But gradually the fire begins to ignite, and once the fire begins to burn properly, then there's no smoke.
但是逐渐的呢，这个火就会燃烧得越来越旺。当这个火真正的燃烧起来的时候，就不会再有浓烟了。
So Krishna says, in performing duty, there will be often some faults. There will be something things which are not very nice.
主 Krishna 也说到呢，当我们在履行职责的过程当中，也许会产生一些不那么令人愉快的事情。
But that is no reason to give up doing your duty.
但是呢，这并不是一个原因让我们放弃去履行职责。
We spoke yesterday about.Some of the problems in performing our different duties.
昨天我们讲到了，当我们在履行不同的职责的时候，会面临到许多不同的困难。
Just like a brahmana, sometimes he has to have to kill an animal, perform an animal sacrifice.
就好比婆罗门，有时候婆罗门他们需要去做动物的祭祀，要去杀死动物。
And kshatriyas, they have to fight in battles, they have to sometimes kill people.
查崔亚呢，有时候也要去上战场去作战，要杀死别人。
And here today, Prabhupada talks about the businessman, that they may often have to do business in the black market.
这个帕帕的在要旨当中也说到，对于商人而言的话，他们有时候甚至要去做黑市的买卖。
Now, Prabhupada had been a businessman himself. At one point, he had his own company.
圣帕帕德他本人就曾经是一个商人，他曾经就是拥有一个公司。
So he's talking, and you could understand maybe he's speaking about his own experience.
也许你们会想他是在讲他自己亲身的经历。
He said sometimes in order to stay in business, you have to do things like avoid paying taxes or work, do the trading in the black market.
有的时候呢，他就说到，有的时候在你做生意的过程当中，你甚至要去就是逃税、去避税，有的时候甚至还要去在那个黑市上做生意。
We see also practicing Krishna consciousness in places like China.
我们也看到，在像中国这样的地方去练习 Krishna 之觉的话。
It's not encouraged by the government.
政府并不是很鼓励。
But if you don't do it, then what do the government want you to do? They want you to be a good communist party member.
那政府想要你们做什么呢? 政府需要你们成为一个非常守法的公民。
So good communist party member means You might be materially happy in this lifetime, but what will be your destination in the next life?
那作为一个好的公民意味着什么呢？这意味着，也许你在这一生当中得到了很多的物质的快乐，但是你的下一生又会去哪里呢？
You do not get peace of mind. You will not get. It does not mean that if you're a good party member, a good communist person, it does not mean that you would have peace of mind.
就成为一个好的公民，并不意味着你就是拥有一个很好的心意，你的心意非常的平和。
Prabhupada also talks about the sudra. The sudra sometimes have to serve people who are nasty, who are wicked.
圣帕帕的也提到了sudra。
We have to serve these people just in order to maintain our life, just to have some job. We have to have some means to maintain our life. We get some money from these people, but we have to work for them. You have to serve them. You have to be like a slave.
我们要为这样的一些令人憎恶的人去工作，仅仅是为了谋生而已。我们仅仅是希望得到一份工作，能够维系自己的生存。而为了得到这个生存呢，我们就必须为这样的人去工作，成为他们的奴隶。
So Prabhupada said, the perfection is just to do your duty, understanding you're doing it for Krishna.
像帕帕的解释道，完美意味着你只是去履行你的职责，而且你履行的职责是为了 Krishna 而做的。And
even the work which we're doing, may not do it perfectly, but that's not important.
即便我们在履行职责的过程当中并不是很完美，但是这并不是最重要的。Just
like it's described in the Srimad Bhagavatam, the books. Like Srimad Bhagavatam may have many mistakes in the book.
正如圣严伯加瓦坛里面解释说，就像圣严伯加瓦坛这样的书籍，其中也许可能会有许多的错误。
There may be so many things which are wrong, word meanings, spellings, so many things faults may be there.
其中有可能会有一些错误，比如说文法上的错误，拼写的错误。
But Narada Muni told Vyasadeva that because these words are meant to glorify the Lord, they are perfect.
但是Narada Muni对Vyasadeva说道呢，因为这些字句都是用来荣耀至尊主的，因此没有错误，因此是完美的，没有错误。So
these words are heard, sung, and accepted by men who are honest.
这个师姐所发出的这个声音震荡，受到正直的人所接受。Now
there may be other books which are perfect grammar and every word is perfect spelling, perfect construction of the sentence. But if they do not glorify Krishna, they're useless.
而其他的书籍，哪怕是他们的文法是正确的，语法也是正确的，这个结构也是完美的。 但是如果这些师姐没有去荣耀 Krishna 的话，那这些书籍就不是完美，就没有什么用。
These books are compared to a place, just like a place of pilgrimage for crows. A place of pilgrimage for the crow.
这个书呢就被比喻成是乌鸦去朝拜的地方。
Right? We know about crows, right?
我们知道乌鸦。
You can see them if you don't know, go to Calcutta.
如果你们没见过乌鸦的话，可以去加尔各答。
Just go in the city of Calcutta, walk around for some time, you'll see lots of crows.
在如果你们去加尔各答，就在这个街上溜达几圈的话，就会看见很多的乌鸦。
And where do they go for their pilgrimage?
他们会去什么样的地方去朝圣呢？
They don't come to Mayapur.
他们不会来 Mayapur.
They don't go to Vrindavan.
他们也不会去 Vrindavan.
They go to the garbage.
他们会去找垃圾堆。
Yeah, they look for a nice big pile of rubbish, and they will go there, and they will enjoy.
他们会去寻找这个成堆的垃圾，去从里面找东西享乐。
Maybe they will find a dead rat there.
也许他们会在那里面发现一只死掉的老鼠。
Oh, they can have a big feast.
这样的话，他们就可以饱餐一顿。
You'll see all the crows come and eat.
然后你就会看到有成群的这个乌鸦都过来吃。
Or sometimes a dog gets run over by a car.
或者是这个狗有的时候就跟着这个汽车跑。
Then all the crows will come. They will have a feast.
这个就是这个狗被这个汽车撞死了，这个乌鸦就跑过来吃这个死掉的狗。
So the crows, they like to go to these kind of places.To the garbage, they enjoy there.
乌鸦就喜欢到这样的地方，像垃圾一样的地方，然后去享乐。
In the same way, people who are like these crows, they like to read literature, which are of a similar nature.
同样的，就是像乌鸦一样的人呢，也会去寻找那些跟他们本性一样的这个书籍。
They won't read Srimad Bhagavatam or Bhagavad Gita.
他们不会阅读圣严伯嘉瓦堂或者伯嘉梵歌。
They will look to some kind of pornography magazine.
他们会去找一些那个时尚的杂志去看。
This is like the place of pilgrimage for the soul.
这就好比是乌鸦的朝圣之地。
So there are books for people who are like crows, and there are books for people who are like swans.
所以有的书籍呢是给那些像乌鸦一样的人去看的，而有的书籍是写给天鹅般的人去看的。
The crows, they have their nature, and the swan has their nature.
乌鸦有他们的天性，天鹅也有他们的天性。
People who are like crows.They have one nature, and people who are like swans, they have a different nature.
有像乌鸦一样的人有他们的天性，而像天鹅一样的人呢，有另外的不同的天性。
And there are literature for people like crows, and literature for people like swans.
因此呢，有的文献书籍就是给那些乌鸦一样的人去看的，而有的文献书籍是写给天鹅般的人去看的。
And the nature of this literature does not depend on material considerations.
这个书籍的超然的书籍，它并不依赖于物质的物质品性。
We may say, "Oh no, this word is not spelled rightly, or this sentence is not proper."
也许我们会说，哦，这个单词拼写不正确，这句话没有。说正确。
Just like Prabhupada went to America with the first canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam printed in India.
圣帕帕德去到美国的时候，他随身带着一本在印度印刷出版的《圣典伯嘉瓦坛》第一篇。
So in 1960s, there was no computers. Everything was done by letter.
在19世纪70年代的时候呢，那个时候并没有这个印刷设备，都是用打字机打印出来的。
Yeah, you had to type each letter and then make a block with that letter and put the blocks together to print a page.
他们要用这个打字机把这个每一个单词打出来，然后打出来之后又贴在这个纸张上面。
So it took a long time and a lot of work to put a book together.
所以要把整本书整合在一起的话，需要大量的工作，并且需要花很长的时间。
And Prabhupada was working alone. He was doing everything himself.
而帕帕的他是独自完成这些工作的。他只有他一个人在去做所有的事情。
So there were many mistakes in the book.
所以书籍当中就不可避免地出现了一些错误。
But the book is perfect because in every page would be the word Krishna.
但是呢，这他的书是完美的，因为书里的字里行间，书里的每一页都是 Krishna 亲自讲述的。
Prabhupada's spiritual master, Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati.Was publishing a daily newspaper.
圣帕帕德的灵性导师萨拉刷蒂巴提西丹塔萨拉刷蒂塔库尔，他出版了一个每日的书刊。
So people would bring articles to be printed in his publication.
然后人们呢就会带一些文章来，就是在他的杂志上面出版。
So he would simply look and see how many times the name Krishna came.
然后他就看到有很多 Krishna 的名字出现在这个书刊上面。
And if the name Krishna was there, then you say, yes, all right, print.
如果别人给他的这个文章上面，他看到这个文章上面有 Krishna 的名字，他就会说，好，可以，你这个文章可以出版。
So similarly, Prabhupada's Bhagavatam, although there were mistakes in the printing and in editing.But it was a perfect book because it was all glorifying Krishna.
同样的，圣帕帕德所编著的《圣典菩萨瓦坛》当中，也许会不可避免地出现一些小的错误。但是呢，这个他的《菩萨瓦坛》是完美的，因为呢，这本书荣耀了至尊主 Krishna.
The devotees from Russia told me the first Russian Bhagavad Gita.Was a terrible translation.
这个来自于俄罗斯的奉献者就告诉我，在俄罗斯出版的第一本《国家梵歌》当中的这个翻译真的很糟糕。
But it made many devotees.
但是即使是这样很糟糕的翻译，也发展出了很多的奉献者。
It does not have anything to do with the material quality.
所以这个超然的文献和物质的品性是没有任何关系的。
These books are fully spiritual.
这些书籍都完全是超然的。
Spiritual means they're in relation to Krishna.
超然就意味着这些书籍是和 Krishna 紧密相连的。
Material means what has no connection to Krishna.
物质便意味着跟 Krishna 没有关系，没有跟 Krishna 相连。
So material things, that is for the crows.
物质的东西就是给乌鸦去看的。
But the spiritual things are for the swans.
而灵性的呢，是为天鹅去准备的。
We want to become like the swan.
我们都想成为天鹅。
Just like there's a person called Paramahamsa.
就比方说有一个词叫 Paramahamsa.
Hamsa means swan.
Hamsa 的意思就是天鹅。
So Paramahamsa means the best swan.
Paramahamsa 就是最好的那个天鹅，至尊天鹅。
Swan knows how to separate milk from water.
天鹅，它非常善于从水里面分离牛奶。
They will drink the milk, leave the water.
他们喝牛奶的时候呢，只是喝这个牛奶，然后把里面的水分留下来。
So we want to become like that. We will take the nectar. We will take the good thing, leave the bad thing.
所以我们也想要如此。我们希望去吸收好的东西，然后把这个糟粕扔掉。
So Prabhupada explains this example. He said, just like when you light the fire.Smoke is not good, but fire is good.
圣帕帕的在这里就举了一个例子，比如说当你点火的时候，这个火里面会冒出烟，这个烟是不好的，但是火是好的。
So in everything we do, there's going to be some fault.
我们无论做什么事情呢，其中都可能会有一些缺陷。
But because we're trying to do it for Krishna, there's no fault.
但是呢，如果我们是为 Krishna 而做的，这就没有缺陷了。
There's no failure in trying to serve Krishna.
在尝试服务 Krishna 的这个过程当中是没有失败的。
Lord Nityananda and Haridas Thakur went to Jagai and Madhai.
But
on the first attempt, they failed.
Lord Nityananda and Haridas Thakur went to Jagai and Madhai, but in their first attempt, they failed.
It appears like they failed because they had to run to save their life.
看起来是如此，因为呢，他们不得不逃跑来保存性命。
But actually, there's no failure in serving Krishna.
但是实际上，在服务 Krishna 的过程当中是没有失败的。
One time in Srila Prabhupada's time, the devotees were sent to Japan to distribute books.
有一次呢，在圣帕帕德的时代，有一位奉献者被派到了日本去派书。
This was in the 1970s.
这是在19世纪70年代。
So at that time, the Japanese economy was quite good.
The Japan. 那个时候的日本的经济是非常好的。
So devotees were going there distributing books, and they were making a good profit.
所以奉献者们呢就会去日本去派书，然后从这派书当中赚取很多的利润。
But sometimes the authorities, the government, did not like it.
但是有的时候这个政府不是很欢迎。
And some devotees, they were sent back. They were sent away.
他们这个奉献者呢就被政府给遣走了。
So somehow this news came in the newspapers that, oh, Hare Krishna people were sent away, sent out of Japan.
然后这个消息呢就被这个新闻的记者知道了，然后他们就在这个报纸上报道了一条消息，就说 Hare Krishna 人们被赶出了日本。
So some of Prabhupada's godbrothers, they saw the newspaper article and they questioned him about this.
圣帕帕德的一些神兄弟看到这个新闻的报道之后就质问帕帕。
They said, how is it your disciples, they could go to Japan and they were sent out of the country?
然后他们就质问帕帕德，你的这些门徒怎么去了日本，然后又被人家赶出日本呢？
They said, this is very bad.
他们说这是很丢人的。
But Prabhupada said no.
但是帕帕德却说不是这样。
He said, they went there. You did not even go there.
圣帕帕德回答说，他们已经去了那里，而你们甚至连那里都没有去过。
You're just sitting here in your India, in your holy place. You don't want to go to these places. And try to spread Krishna consciousness.
你们呢，只是待在你们自己的这个国家，待在印度，你们都没有愿望去到那些地方去传播 Krishna 知觉。
So they went there, and they were trying to distribute Krishna consciousness.
而我的那些奉献者们呢，却去了那里，并且在那里去传播了 Krishna 知觉，去派发了 Krishna 知觉。
That is a success.
那就是成功。
If you don't try to distribute Krishna consciousness, then there's no credit. You haven't done anything.
那如果你甚至没有尝试去开发 Krishna 知觉，那你就没有任何的荣誉可言，你什么都没有做。
You may not be successful. That's not important.
你也许就是在这个尝试的过程当中并没有成功，但是呢，这不是最重要的。
What is important is that we try to serve Krishna.
更重要的是我们竭尽全力地去服务 Krishna.
So like the Lord Krishna is encouraging Arjuna to do his duty.
所以在这里呢，主 Krishna 在鼓励 Arjuna 去履行他的职责。
We're attached to doing the duty, we're not attached to the results.
我们要依附地去履行职责，但是不要依附 工作的结果。
Krishna has explained this in the third chapter.
Krishna 在梵歌的第三章当中解释过了这一点。
Karmani vadikaraste mapaleshu kadachana na karma palahiturbur matesangos vakarmani. You have a right to do your duty, but you are not entitled to enjoy the results.
主奎师那在第三章当中说到，你有权利去履行你的固定职责，但是你没有权利去享受工作的结果。
Never consider yourself to be the cause of the results.
永远不要认为你自己是工作结果的行为者。
And don't be attached to not doing your duty.
也不要不依附的去不去履行职责。
So this is the principle of karma yoga.
这是karma业报瑜伽的原则。
Krishna is explaining here karma yoga.
Krishna 在这里描述了karma yoga业报瑜伽。
And he's going to go on and explain later in a few verses. He'll begin to explain about bhakti yoga.
然后在接下来的几个世界当中，他继续地描述了巴提瑜伽、奉爱瑜伽。
Any questions?